For days now, Tonga has been virtually cut off from the outside world. But this morning, an Australian Defence Force flight took off from Brisbane. One of the first reconnaissance missions to the country deployed some 36 hours after the volcanic eruption.
Obviously, getting flights over due to the ash cloud and some of the conditions has been virtually impossible.
Thick volcanic ash still looming over the island nation, as are questions over the extent of devastation.
This is a very challenging time. Communications are deeply, deeply affected by the events of the volcanic eruption.
As reports of the volcano's impact continue to filter in from countries across the Pacific, from Japan, the US and Peru, little information has emerged from Tonga. But it's hoped more will be known in the coming days. New Zealand has also sent a surveillance flight to assess the damage. The country, along with Australia, preparing to send humanitarian aid to the kingdom. Still, it remains difficult to know exactly what is needed.
At the moment, we are relying on information often that's being received third-hand via family members on the ground or via leaders, church leaders and so on. The flights undertaken today will help us establish what needs there might be.
The first images have also come in from the Ha’apai group of islands closer to the volcano. They show damage to buildings and homes. The Tongan Deputy High Commissioner in Australia says there have been no confirmed deaths so far. And with the country reporting just one case of COVID-19 throughout the pandemic and infections running rife in Australia, he's concerned humanitarian assistance could arrive along with the virus.
Making sure that it is strictly safe to send assistance to Tonga, but in the meantime, we do not take COVID to Tonga. You know, I think that's going to be another disaster if we rush into sending assistance.
New Zealand-based Kakalu O'Tonga, the former editor of the Tonga Times, is one of few to have made contact with those on the ground, a friend calling him via satellite phone this morning.
This person told me this morning the whole of Tonga has been covered with ashes. It's a few inches, the thickness of it is a few inches. And that's what they really need now is clean drinking water.
Kakalu O'Tonga relieved to have received the update from his friend after an agonising 2 days of zero communication. But for most in the Tongan diaspora, the desperate wait continues. Brisbane-based Minister Fermatangi has been unable to reach her husband since Saturday.
Quite an anxious weekend where I've just felt my heart just very heavy, really heavy with worry and anxiety. The only thing I could do was hit the refresh button and see what updates there were. So, I'm sorry.
And while their homeland may feel further away than ever, it would appear Tongans from around the world have never been closer. A marathon online vigil organised by Brisbane broadcaster Pacifica TV and Radio, bringing the diaspora together.
Well, we had inundated with calls from the United States of America, Hawaii, Fiji, New Zealand, Australia, but even more interesting from Tongan communities in Sweden, Germany, Austria, Japan.
Some comfort amid excruciating uncertainty. Abby O'Brien, SBS World News.